use your fingers to show me how old you are. I can't really do that anymore on my fingers, but we tend to use our fingers to help us count or add up numbers. The Auca tribe that lived in South America and Ecuador, they also use their hands to count, just like you and I. Only they would do it a wee bit different. Instead of saying the number 10 and holding up two hands, they would say the number of two hands. And if they got any bigger than that, sometimes they would even use their toes. Auca language was completely different than any other language on Earth. And yet there were some people who were desperate to learn it. Does anybody remember who these people were? You're right. If you said Nate Saint and Rachel. Nate Saint and Rachel had been working so hard to find a way to reach the Auca people with the good news of the Lord Jesus. And they were so excited when they met Dayoma, a little girl who had run away from the Auca tribe when she was young and had now grown up. But learning the Auca language wasn't going to be easy. For starters, Rachel, when she came and asked Dayoma to help her teach the language, had to ask somebody to interpret for her, to tell her what she wanted, because neither of them spoke the same language. And Dayoma, it had been years since she had been in the Auca tribe, and so there were many words she didn't remember. But each day that Rachel would go and ask Dayoma's help, Dayoma would act out different words, and Rachel would sit and guess until she came to the right word. One day, Dayoma went down on her tummy and began stomping on the ground and making a loud noise until Rachel finally guessed the word crying. Another day, Dayoma told her the word iwa. Can you say iwa? Very good. And she began to act it out like this. See if you can guess what it was. Ready? Anybody guess? If you said monkey, you were correct. Iwa meant the name of a certain monkey that the Auca people really liked to eat. Another word that Dayoma acted out for Rachel was the word wado. Can you say wado? Very good. Now to act this one out, Dayoma pointed up to the sky over and over and over again until Rachel guessed. What do you think she was pointing to? Maybe the clouds? Maybe the sky? But finally, Rachel guessed the word stars. Over and over again, Rachel and Dayoma would meet up and do this little game, learning more and more of the language of the Auca people. Dayoma was also learning things from Rachel, though. As she taught Rachel the words from the Auca tribe, Rachel was also speaking to her through the interpreter. And one day, Dayoma was shocked to see that Rachel got a message from Nate Saint from missionaries on the other part of the jungle. Dayoma was fascinated. How could you get a message from someone who lived hundreds of miles away from here? And when Rachel got this message, she told Dayoma that God had a message for Dayoma. God had a message for her? Remember at the very beginning of the story when we learned about Dayoma when she was a little girl, and that Dayoma had gone and asked one of her relatives to tell her about God? But the people didn't really know about the one true God, and the God they believed had come, made the earth, and then left and never come back. And now Dayoma was being told that there is a real God who is different than that God and who had a message for her. Dayoma wanted to know what this message was, and so she spent even more time working with Rachel to learn the language so that she could hear what this message really was from God. Well, while all this was going on, Nate was busy in the jungle, flying his yellow airplane all around doing different missions for the missionaries. So maybe some days he would take medicine, other days he would fly messages back and forth. One day, Nate got a message from a missionary, and he said that they needed him to come quickly. When he landed on the ground, he saw some people from one of the nearby tribes, and these tribes had run into the Auca people and had been speared and hurt very badly by the Auca people. Nate quickly got the injured people onto his plane. Maybe you can do that with me. Let's carry them carefully onto the plane. Very good. And he flew them as quickly as he could to the doctor. Thankfully, these people survived. They were able to get better. But these people didn't really know the Lord Jesus. And so when this happened to them from the Auca tribe, they were angry. Maybe you can make an angry face. Oh, very good. They were so angry that they said to Neat Saint, "We will pay you to fly back into the jungle and to shoot the Auca people for us." Now, do you think Neat Saint wanted to do that? No, of course he didn't. He wanted to tell them about the Lord Jesus, and he wanted them to stop killing the people around them. But Neat knew that he wasn't going to be able to do this alone. He needed a team of people that would help him to reach the Auca people with the good news of the Lord Jesus. And thankfully for Neat, God had already provided this team. There are many other missionaries that already lived in the jungle of Ecuador. And we're going to find out that each one of these people had something in common. Let's look at each of these people and pretend like we are going with Neat Saint in his yellow plane to fly to each different family. So everybody get on your plane, buckle up your seatbelt, and let's go. Ready? First, we're going to stop with a man named Roger. Now, Roger and his wife lived in the jungle, and Roger wanted to tell the Auca people about the Lord Jesus. One day, he had met a chief from a nearby tribe who had been near the Auca people, and he had gotten sick. Roger went to this man and prayed for him, and the Lord Jesus healed this man. Roger and his wife would meet up with Neat whenever he came and flew them supplies, and they were so excited to find a way to tell the Auca people about the Lord Jesus. All right, now it's time to get in our plane and fly to the next family in the jungle. So everyone buckle up, and here we go. Now, the next family they went to visit were Jim and Betty Elliott. Jim and Betty Elliott lived in the jungles of Ecuador, and they wanted to tell the Auca people about the Lord Jesus. Whenever Neat Saint would come and visit them, he and Jim would sit and talk for hours upon hours about how they could reach the Auca people and how much they loved them and wanted them to know about the Lord Jesus. Neat Saints loved sitting with Jim and Betty, but he couldn't stay for long because there were many jobs he needed to do around the jungle. So he flew on. Another family that Nate would go to meet would be Ed and his family. Now, Ed and his family were building a brand new house on the edge of the Auca's land. Many times, Nate would fly to him and bring supplies or maybe just stop and have a cup of coffee on their breaks. He would help him build his house, and they would chat for hours about how much all of them wanted to tell the Auca people about the Lord Jesus and how they could do that. But maybe in the middle of stopping and talking to Ed, Nate would get a message from his friend Pete. Can you pretend to hold up your radio and pretend to be Pete radioing Nate through his airplane? One day, Pete sent him a message saying, Nate, come quick, come quick. And so Nate would get in his plane, let's get in our plane, buckle up, and fly over to Pete through the jungle. And Pete would oftentimes have people that Nate needed to take to the doctor. Pete would always help the people with medicine and what they needed, and Nate would fly them to where they needed to go. Each of these people, each of these families in the jungle had come with one reason. What was the thing that they all had in common? That's right. They had all come to tell the Auca people about the Lord Jesus. But they knew that this needed to happen quickly. Because you see, more and more people were getting hurt by the Auca tribe. More and more times, the Auca tribe were running into tribes around them or even going to hurt and to kill people in the tribes around them. And these people were beginning to get more and more angry to the point that they were talking about going and killing all of the Auca tribe, getting rid of them for good. Well, Nate and the missionaries knew that this wasn't the answer, and they wanted to tell the Auca tribe about the Lord Jesus so that they would stop this killing. But how would they do that? They didn't even know where the Auca tribe lived. They knew the area, but this area was big and thick with the jungle foliage, with the trees and the plants. How would they find them? Well, Nate had an idea. What if they got up in his yellow plane and flew over this area and looked for the huts that Daoma described to them to know where the Aucas lived? Nate and some of the missionary friends would get up and get in their plane every day and fly over the jungle, looking here and there, trying to find the Auca tribes. Maybe you can pretend to be Nate and his missionary friends in the plane, looking out of their airplane, trying to find. For days and days and hours, they looked and looked until finally they saw a hut, and they were so excited. They found the Aucas. Now they could go and reach them with the Lord Jesus. But they knew that this information had to be a secret. If the other tribes found out that they knew where the Aucas lived, they might come and try and hurt them to try and get this information so they could go and kill the Aucas. Nate and his missionary friends had to be careful and had to plan so that they could go and reach the Aucas with the good news of the Lord Jesus. But would they make it there in time? Would the other tribes find them first? How would they even tell the Auca people about the Lord Jesus when they still knew so few words from their language? Well, to find out, you're going to have to come back next week to find the next part of our true story of Operation Auca.